Hello again, historical people, and welcome to round two. i33 techniques, but with a Viking round shield, because I like round shields, what can I say? If you saw the last video, you'll know we covered a few positions, the Halpschilt, first, second, third Custodia, and I shared my sort of thoughts on those. If you haven't seen that video, I'll put the link in the description to go check it out. And yeah, the main thing that I was concerned about in the first one was just the weight of that shield. With the added weight and size of a round shield, you have to modify a lot of these i33 techniques for them to work with you. So, does that keep the core of the technique, or are they totally different techniques with a round shield? You know, you decide, but let's get into it. So, I did this one in the previous video, but I did it wrong. So, this is the fourth Custodia shown correctly, except with a round shield. So, still not correctly, but you get my drift. Now, with the shield in front of me, it provides a little bit more protection from any return thrusts and things like that. It's quite good, actually. I can move the shield around that easy. And with that hand nice and high, I've got so many more attacks I can run off that one. So I do like the fourth Custodia done right. So we're going to move into the fifth Custodia now, which is quite a good one. I've actually got my wrist turned the wrong way on that. The sword should be pointing directly out behind me. However, this one's not too bad. Again, I tried with the outstretched arm. It didn't really work, so I brought that shield in closer. And it's quite nice. If I'd have had that shield in front of me, actually, similar to in the fourth Custodia, then it would have hid my blade a lot more. So I could have tricked my opponents, or at least had a little bit more time on my side when attacking. So the only thing I'd change about that is bringing that shield in front of me. But overall, yeah, it works quite well. It's nice. Gives you nice powerful attacks off the back of that. This is the sixth Custodia. Now, I like this one because you can use the tip of the sword to take the weight off your shield, and it also hides the blade, similar to the previous one, if I'd have done that one right. But my problem is I kept getting the sword stuck in the rim of the shield, whether that's my shield design or my poor, poor sword technique. I found sometimes it sticks, so I wouldn't use that contact, and I'd bring that shield closer in going forward. But overall, yeah, it's a pretty sound technique. It's good. If you don't make that contact with the shield, it'll work quite nicely. So again, this is where I'm saying we have to modify a lot of the techniques we see in the book here. Obviously, it's a book about bucklers, so it shouldn't be expected to work for round shields, but it's a fun experiment. So this one's Custodia. This one's a seventh Custodia, Langort. And I actually found pressing my sword hand into the shield there does take some of the weight off it. So for an extended arm guard position or whatever, it actually isn't too bad. You've not got the full weight of the shield pulling down on your arm. You've got both arms resting it. I still wouldn't stay there forever, but it's definitely plausible. If I was trying to move in for an attack or something, I could deal with that. That's fine. You know, it's not the worst. So, let's move on to some of the priest specials now. So we've got the priest special Custodia, and I thought this one was not going to work. I thought this one would just get completely covered by the shield. But playing with it, it actually clears the shield absolutely fine. I don't even think I've had to bring the shield particularly high on that. That's just pretty natural position. And yeah, you can just, boom, attack straight from there. It's actually quite nice. So again, leaves your sword arm quite exposed to attacks, so you got to be careful on that one. It's not one I'd prioritize using. It's definitely a bait attack to try and get them to attack you first, but it's not terrible. It's rather enjoyable. I'm glad it works, actually, because it looks fancy on the book, so it should work really. Now, this next one I hated. This Custodia Crooker, or Crookie, I'm not sure how to pronounce it. But with that sort of raised up there, I thought I could use the same principle and push that sword arm into the shield, take the weight off. Doesn't really work in that position. You haven't got the structure behind you. So, you know, it was just a bit heavy and a bit naff. Can't say I find myself in that position too often when sparring, so it's not a useful one for me, but it might be worth playing around with a little more. So that's my opinion on that one. Now, this next one, the Walpurgis Custodia. Let me finish messing about with the crookie. So the Walpurgis Custodia. Now, I didn't rate this one when I saw the picture, but actually playing with it, it's really quite good. It's like a, you know, it reminds me of like a close-up, you're in a shield wall sort of thing. It's pretty legit. Like, you can move the shield around wherever you want. You got that frontal coverage, and your sword's not really blocked by the shield at all, because you've got that freedom of movement, being central. So I actually really like this one. Yeah, you can do all sorts with it. It's nice. It sort of hides your blade. They can still see the tip of the blade. So, you know, it's not that great, but it's nice. You can throw quite a lot from there. Nothing, no big heavy attacks, because you'd have to draw back and fall out the Custodia for that. But yeah, overall it's good. I quite like that one. The Walpurgis Custodia. So, as I'm over there, again, so some of these, like you say, they just need that modification for them to be feasible with a round shield. You're dealing with a lot more weight and size. Again, our shields might not be historically accurate, but that's what we use. So this one's fun. This is the rare Contraria. Now, I keep seeing this one, and I thought I'd give it a go. I do use this type of technique with the buckler quite a bit, and it worked quite nicely. But with a round shield, again, it's just that weight. If you keep the shield nice and tucked in, you can see I'm bloody running out of stamina as it is, and I've only done 2 days of this. So yeah, you've got that freedom of movement with your sword, your shield's not getting in the way. It's pretty good. So on the image, they've got the shield completely outstretched, like you see there when I do the punch, but it's just not feasible, so you've got to keep it close. And I guess that's the secret with round shield, keep it close, otherwise you're going to be knackered. You know, and that's me playing around with the sword, because I've tired myself out playing with buckler techniques for the shield. Again, hope you found this useful. Let me know if there's any other guard positions or manuals or any other buckler references even that would be worth me checking out for my little experiment. And I suppose the next thing now is to put all of this into sparring and see if I can pull or use any of these to any effect against an opponent that either doesn't like me or is actively trying to not let me use my silly buckler techniques with my shield. Well, hopefully, look forward to bringing that one to you soon. Take care, guys. Like I say, thoughts, opinions, and all that good stuff, chuck them in the comments below. Subscribe and like the video if you liked it. And subscribe to me if you like me, or if you don't like me and want to keep making sure that I'm not causing any trouble, yeah, hit the button, mate. Right, see you in a bit.